Within northeastern Papua New Guinea, on the island of New Britain, is the massive Simpson Harbor, which, due to its natural origin, has allowed the town of Rabaul and its surrounding regions to grow to include 200,000 residents. Yet, there is a problem with this major harbor. The reason it is so deep, with sections of Simpson Harbor being more than 200 feet depth, is due to the fact that it represents a section of a largely submerged caldera from the still active and potentially destructive volcano known as Rabaul. In fact, there are multiple calderas present, the last of which formed in only 683 CE in an eruption which destroyed all life in a 10-mile radius. That specific eruption was far larger than witnessed at Hunga Tunga Hunga Haapai in January of 2022, as the 683 Rabaul eruption ejected 24 cubic kilometers of tephra, being assigned a volcanic explosivity index of a 6. Within this caldera are this volcano's two most active cones, which, despite being located on opposite sides of a bay or 3.75 miles apart, sometimes erupt simultaneously. As the Rabaul volcano does not consist of a single towering central vent, nor does it represent a series of cinder cones which each only erupt once. Instead, this volcano contains 13 separate stratocones which each have erupted dozens of times, with the majority containing the potential to erupt again in the future. For example, in the last 600 years, four of these vents have been active, with Rabaulankia last erupting in 1450, Sulphur Creek last erupting in 1850, Vulcan last erupting in 1994, and Tavurvor last erupting in 2014. If we look at how many vents have erupted after its 683 caldera-forming eruption, the number of vents is 9. All of these are located within the most recent caldera, suggesting that perhaps the other four vents are actually extinct. This unusual dynamic, where multiple primary vents miles apart can erupt simultaneously, makes Rabaul a truly unique and potentially deadly volcano. Adding to the strangeness of this volcano, Rabaul could not only be considered a caldera, but also a type of shield volcano. Its fairly gentle slopes are not immediately visible, but when I display labeled elevation data, it becomes much easier to spot. Rabaul is no ordinary shield volcano, but rather a rare and explosive variant known as a pyroclastic shield volcano. Pyroclastic shields produce numerous ash-rich eruptions with fairly frequent planing eruptions that are low in height but broad in width, dispersing ash and pyroclastic flow deposits over an unusually vast area. Thus, instead of runny lava forming a gentle slope, ash and pyroclastic flow deposits form it. This thick ashfall was all too familiar for those who live in the city of Rabaul, as numerous buildings were destroyed due to the weight of heavy rain-soaked ash that fell during the 1994 eruption, totaling more than 30 centimeters on some structures. For those of you in my audience who live in colder climates, 30 centimeters of wet ash is equivalent in weight to up to 18 meters or 59 feet thick of snow. While Rabaul itself has only been erupting for 100,000 years, you can trace some precursor volcanoes back to 500,000 years ago. Each of these volcanoes collapsed into large calderas, but over time migrated northwards. During this 100,000-year time span, Rabaul has produced a VEI-6 explosive eruption on four separate occasions, with these being responsible for the formation of its large complex caldera. Vents such as Tovanum Batir and Kombio formed during the first 50,000 years, but then for some reason volcanism settled slightly to the south and southwest, perhaps being caused by the proximity to the separate Tavi volcano. Rabaul has erupted on 13 occasions in the last 100 years, with two of these involving simultaneous eruptions of both Vulcan and Tavurvor, with the remaining eruptions solely occurring from Tavurvor. Today, those who live in the vicinity face the risk when an eruption occurs of heavy ashfall, occasional pyroclastic flows, and volcanic ejecta, sometimes requiring the widespread evacuation of the area surrounding these two separate volcanic cones and the city of Rabaul itself. Thanks for watching. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron Alan Olson for increasing their patron tier on this channel's Patreon page.